Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. catastrophic storms that did not occur in these months. The dangers posed by these storms.
Thank you. Dinosaur is impressive. The Spinosaurus is perhaps the largest of carnivores. Of course, I'll never get close enough to one to see for myself, but that's why I have you.
Hi, I'm Claire Deering. I know it must be overwhelming to meet all these new people, but you're about to embark on a life-changing adventure. It certainly was for me. Trust me, you'll understand. There isn't a more iconic dinosaur than the T-Rex. Even people who don't know the difference between herbivore and carnivore know all about the Tyrannosaurus Rex. And when you see her up close, feel her gaze, you understand why the T-Rex was the ruler of the Cretaceous period.
I hope you understand how vitally important this is. Oh, I haven't introduced myself. Dr. Kajal Dua, you need to be as passionate about our work as I am. I'll accept no less. The more I've studied these animals, the more I've noticed that there's a fine line between fascination and fear. Prehistoric flying reptiles like the archetypal pteranodon have captivated my imagination since I was young. Yet there's something about these creatures that makes me feel somewhat cagey, shall we say?
If you don't think nature can be bonkers at times, then you've never laid eyes on this newest animal, the Geosternbergia. However, it is apparently graceful in the air. Not that I would know, but isn't that your job?
None of this would exist. He has that drive and intensity that few people possess. My advice? Don't get on his bad side.
This massive specimen is called the Apatosaurus, an impressive animal that can intimidate even the most determined of predators. The Apatosaurus's evolutionary advantages are its size and its demeanor.
Some of these animals present a real test of our abilities. Take, for instance, this latest dinosaur, the Gallimimus. It's an opportunistic omnivore that does best in groups. That alone isn't the problem, but the speed. Gallimimus is incredibly fast, which presents special challenges for the ranger teams tasked with monitoring them.
Spinosaurus. I call it an armored ball of walking, breathing trouble. Still, some might call it charming, amusing, delightful. Each to their own.
Tell you the truth, even if you don't want to hear it. My advice? Listen when he speaks. Owen has the experience, and he spent more time face to snout with the dinosaurs than just about anyone else. And he lived to tell the tale, and brag about it.
While dinosaurs once ruled the Earth, other animals ruled the seas. Take the ichthyosaurus, a perfect example of what I'm talking about. They have a large dorsal fin, much like a dolphin. Or actually more like a shark.
My name is Isaac Clement, and it's great to finally meet you. I hope you're ready, because the dinosaurs can't wait to meet you too. So when people come to the park, they want to learn something, sure, but they also want to be entertained. And this marine reptile, the Mosasaurus, is just that, a showstopper. If the T-Rex is the ruler of the dinosaurs on land, then the Mosasaurus holds that title below the waves. Make sure this animal is a premium attraction.
Thank you.
Everyone knows I have a soft spot for this dinosaur, the Velociraptor. And they get a bad rap as far as I'm concerned. But if you imprint early enough, you can make real connections with them. Other than Claire, raptors are the most intelligent partners I've ever had. And like her, they can kill me in the blink of an eye. That's a joke.
Often has his hands full with claws and teeth and tails.
What can be said about the Triceratops? This is one of those dinosaurs that really defines our business. People want to see them, and we want to share them with the world. Don't let that fearsome appearance fool you. Those horns are mostly for defense and impressing other Triceratops. This animal is an herbivore. It can be a star attraction or a security nightmare if it turns those horns on our fancy.
Now that we have them to study, perhaps we can look.